Hi everybody, this is Patty. I'm here today with a design team project for Cut at Home, and I'm going to show you how I put this card together. I am not going to show you how I assembled the flowers, but I will leave a link to a video that I use that shows you exactly how to put the flowers together. This is my card today. It's using three different dies and a stamp set. The flowers are stephanotis, I think that's how you pronounce it. And I have three of those with some pearls, flatback pearls from Sawcrafters. And then the filigree background piece is a Spellbinders card creator. This is the Tudor Rose card front. I love this. And I showed you in the video, you know, I cut it out in several colors trying to decide what I wanted to use. Oh, it's just gorgeous in whatever color you decide to cut it out in. And that's this die here. This is the Susan's Garden stephanotis that is the flowers. Then I use the Tim Holtz butterfly, which you get not only the die, but you get the embossing folder as well. This one. And that's what the butterfly is here. It comes in two different sizes. What I wanted to show you on camera is how I put it together. I just had a little bit of netting that came off of an edge of some flowers that I had, and I had just thrown it in a basket here on my desk, and I used that for the body. And then I put some of the new Angel Craft Mod Podge on the antenna. Now stay tuned, because we're going to have a video real soon introducing this new Mod Podge, and I love it. It is fantastic. But I used it on the butterfly antenna. This one isn't quite dry yet, but this one is very stiff and just hold shape. So that's another way that you can use that. So this is the card. I left the inside blank because I wasn't sure what I wanted to put on it. And I have used a stamp from the Just Right Clear Stamps. This is the Black Eyed Susan set. So I'll probably come in and talk a little bit as I make the card. So enjoy. If you're not a subscriber, please subscribe, like, and comment today. Thanks for joining me, everyone. Bye-bye. This is just a standard regular card base. And here's my, what is this? Tudor Rose front and all the different colors I cut it in. So when I have time, I can go back and make all of these up into cards. I love that pink with the brown. Can't wait to make that. I just did a mat for the front to go underneath the yellow, and a mat for the inside because the green is quite dark. You wouldn't be able to see anything on it if you wanted to write a note. Now you'll notice I didn't put any glue or sticky at the top because, as you'll see in a little bit, I was trying to decide if I wanted to add a little, the other little cutout piece from the die to the top of it that says smile. So I left that, so if I decided to want to put a brad or something through it, I could. I'm going to use the Angel Craft tape to show you how I made this rosette here out of the lace. I just cut a piece of cardstock, put the half inch tape over the top, took the liner off, and then you just pleat your lace, just lay it down on the tape and pleat it. Very, very simple way to add a little bit of adornment to something. So just trying to decide where I want to place that and the flowers. Here's all the flowers. You get two leaves and five of the little petals. And what I was showing you right there was how glossy those leaves are. Notice when I glue them down, I put the Mod Podge over those two, and they give them a waxy kind of look. Really neat. Love that. So I'm just using my hot glue. I have it off camera, but just my hot glue there. Went to use my other hot glue gun today and couldn't get it to work right, and the whole thing had melted. I just could not believe it. So I guess I'm going to be in search of a new hot glue gun again. I wanted to kind of show you how I made this Tim Holtz butterfly. This is a Biggs by Sizzix, and you get not only the die, but you get the embossing folder. And I used the new cracked pistachio around the edges of it. brings out that distressing so pretty. And then I did some sponge sugar, and I'm doing it just like I did it for my card. And then I realized, geez, it's a little too pink for what I have. So I have this Lindy's, what is this? Winter Jasmine Gold, and I sprayed it because I kind of wanted more of the colors. But it's really a pretty effect. I did put some diamond stickles over the top. I had this piece of netting. It came off of a row of flowers. You could use any netting or tulle. And I just tied it around the center of the butterfly, knotted it, trimmed it off, and then I took the Mod Podge, the Angel Craft Mod Podge that will be coming out really soon. Watch for it. And I just coated the antenna with it. And I twirled them in my fingers to give them the shape. And then I took my tweezer beads and held them together. This does wash right off of your hands with soap and water or peel off. And you'll see I'm kind of peeling them for quite a few minutes, trying to get the sticky off my hands there. But the antenna here have dried, and I put some stickles on them. Oh, they just worked out beautiful. Now I can't figure out where to put my butterfly. And just as I put it down, I remember, uh-oh, I didn't stamp my verse yet. So this is the Just Right Stampers, the Black Eyed Susan stamp set. And I'm stamping this one that says Find True Joy and Share It with Others in the middle. Couldn't decide where I wanted it because I knew I wanted to put the butterfly, and now I wished I had put it all the way over to the side because I really wanted the butterfly on the left there, but it just didn't work out. And this is how I make cards, guys. You know, I take it off, put it down, take it off, put it down until I get it to the point where it looks good to me. And that was just plain ugly. That came right off. So finally I gave up and decided it's going to have to go on the right side whether I want it there or not in order to get my sentiment to show. Now I'm going to glue down the top because I decided there's no way I can put that other little piece up there at the top of it. And I have these pearls, and I wanted the big one for the top. And I'm just going to cut some of these flat back pearls off the string because I didn't want to hunt through my whole drawer of bling trying to find my little pearls. And I'm just going to use the hot glue gun and glue those down. See, there's that smile sentiment. Still trying to decide whether I wanted to put it underneath the pearl or not, but it was just too much. It looked funny. So now I'm just going to hot glue them down. Just takes a second here. And then the card is basically done. I love it. I love how the flowers and the lace and the butterfly came together. So thanks for joining me, everybody. Have a great crafty day. Bye now.